KCRA 3 News begins now.
A Roseville intersection opened again after a seven-hour fire in the street last night. The fire caused by an underground gas leak. And tonight we're learning this isn't the first leak reported at this intersection.
KCRA 3's Chris Riva live in Roseville, where the road is open but questions remain. Chris?
Well, Kelly and Walt, the history here started September 7th a year ago. That was 2 days before the San Bruno explosion. And while they're two separate incidents, the San Bruno situation certainly has residents here on heightened alert. 60,000 cars rip through this Roseville intersection each day. Last night, the fire department thinks that one of them sparked this.
It's amazing.
Swirling fire fueled by a gas leak underground. It's not the first time that there's been a leak under this intersection. September 7th of last year, another leak 150 feet from this spot.
We're very concerned, and we share the public's concern for the safety of that intersection. And given the heightened awareness with the safety of gas lines, we've asked PG&E for a meeting to talk about maintenance issues.
You've had two leaks here within 12 months, and there's not a whole lot of answers from PG&E from the standpoint of what happened with the last gas leak.
I don't have the information on the other, particularly on the other leak, as I just came on duty. However, I can tell you that we are investigating this situation. We are going to be getting answers. We can't make any speculation at this point, of course.
PG&E better get their act together.
Not pretty, not good for their reputation.
Late this afternoon, PG&E continued to inspect, making sure there was no more gas leak. They say they'll replace 400 to 500 feet of line in the future while they look into what has happened over the last 12 months.
We are conducting an investigation to see what did cause this gas leak, as well as the one that occurred about a year ago, 150 feet away.
We continued to ask questions well into the afternoon pertaining to the leak that was here September 7th a year ago. Simply put, PG&E's not sure what caused that gas leak. They're not sure what caused the leak last night, and they cannot comment to the fact that there's been two leaks within 150 feet of each other just within the last 12 months. Coming up tonight at 6, what one Roseville resident saw Monday morning about that stretch of the road, the tip that he gave police, and what they did with that tip. Until then, reporting live at Roseville, Chris Riva, KCRA 3 reports.